Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi WordPress theme video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignertechtips.com. Well, Divi have done it again. They brought out an update, and they've included what they call dynamic content. So this video, I'm going to show you how to use a bit of dynamic content for the headers and breadcrumbs on your page. I'm using Divi version 3.19 now. If you want to try Divi out, check below the video. There's my affiliate link down there if you want to check it out. If you're building any sort of WordPress site at all, I would suggest you give Divi a look. It is just absolutely awesome. But anyway, let's go and build something. Let's add a new page. Let's give it a title. Really exciting title there, new content. And let's use the Divi Builder. As you can see, the Divi Builder's loaded. I'm going to start just building from scratch. You can use pre-made layouts or clone an existing page, but I'm just going to build from scratch here. What I'm going to try and achieve in this is I'm going to make a bar that we can use on every page that'll have the page name of the page here, and a breadcrumb, which is basically the link to the page on this side. And each time we use it on a new page, you won't have to change anything because it'll update it dynamically. This is what this new dynamic content's all about. So I've got a new section. Let's add a row. I'm going to add a row of three. So I'll have my page title on the left there, and I'll have a link on the right there. So I'm going to insert a module in the first of the columns here. Just a regular text module. Now, if you look at the field here, you'll notice this little, it's almost like a disk type icon there that's got a little plus next to it. That's for your dynamic content. And what do we want to put in there? We click on it, here's our choices. First one there, that's exactly what we want, which is the page title. Okay, so that's automatically put in the page title of new content up there. Let's just save that. Let's go to the preview. We'll go up to our icons on the top here. Just preview on the desktop version. There it is, new content. Not very exciting. We can make that a bit bigger so it stands out a bit nicer. It'd be nice to put a background image here. And it'd be nice if we got the background image to change with each new page as well. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to go over to unsplash.com and download a couple of images. What I'll do is I'll go back to my builder, the little builder icon right there. I'm going to set a featured image for this page. And let's choose one. I'll just use that one right there. And that's set a featured image for the page, as you see down here, featured image. There it is right there. What I want to do is put that in the background of this whole section here. So what I'm going to do is click on the cog here. I'm going to go to the background. What I'm going to do is go over to image. And if you hover over the field here of add an image, you're going to see another dynamic content here. I'm going to click on that. And I'm going to say featured image. So whatever page you happen to be, if you've got different featured images on the page, then it's going to show you the different image. Okay, and that did not work. Okay, let's try this. I've got a feeling it didn't work because I haven't actually saved the draft. Let's try saving the draft. Now it's saved. Make sure we got that featured image down there. Yep, sure have. Let's try that again. down to background, image. There's our dynamic content right there. Featured image. Great. This time it's actually loaded it in there. So let's have a look. Let's just hit the check mark and see what we've got here. Let's preview it again on the desktop preview icon here. Great. So we've got that image in the background there, which is what we want. We've got our title there, but to me, can't really see that at all. So let's go in and change that new content, our title, make it stand out a lot more. So let's just hit the cog. We can go back and do it in the wireframe view, but I may as well just do it in here. We'll see it in real time. Okay, so we're in there, content, design. Make sure I'm in the right thing here. There we are, this is what I'll be in. There we are, content, there's our page title. Let's go to design. Let's make it a lot bigger and bolder so it stands out. So it's just regular text. So left align's fine. I'm gonna leave it as the default font. Obviously you can change yours to whatever font you fancy. Make the text color white so it stands out. Let's make that text size a lot bigger, like something like 30, 34 maybe. Yeah, that's a bit better. Got a semi-bold there. Yeah, I quite like that. But I'm still having slight problem seeing it over some of that content in the background there. So what we can kind of do is add a background color to that and blend it together. So let's go back into here, go to background. Let's add a background color. Let's say sort of dark blue. That's fine. You can't see any difference at the moment there, but if we go in here and go to our background, to our image here, we'll go down to blend, background image blend, multiply, bit too much there obviously. It's a little better, but no, I think what I want to do is color overlay. There we are, color overlay. That's going to pull it in. That's pretty much taking all of our image away there, which is not quite what we want, but you can read that good. But what I want to do, go back to our color, bring the opacity down, and that'll start to show a lot more of our image. So if I click on our color there and just drag the opacity down, you can see our image start to bleed through there. And I think I'll just leave it about there so we can still see our title, but you can see that little laptop in the background too. So let's just save that. Okay, good. Well, you can read that. That seems to be okay to me, and you can see the background image. Let's put another little text module in here. And again, I'm going to erase what it's got on there. I'm going to use the dynamic content button again. And this time, let's put a page link in. How about that? There we go. And that's probably, yeah, just giving it a sort of name of the page, the link. And if I click on this, give us the option to put something in before that or after that. So before, let's write just home. /. There we go. Now we've got home / new content. I want it fairly small like that, but I want it legible. And my links are set to be light blue in the customizer. So I'll leave that because I can see that quite nicely. So let's just go to the design and to the text again. Let's make it slightly bigger. Let's make it white so it stands out. That's better. And we'll make it, say, 18 pics, maybe. Of course, you have yours just exactly how you want it. Yeah, I think that's perfectly legible there. And why don't we capitalize it? Let's do the two large capitals there. That'll make it all capitals. Yeah, I like that. So let's save that. And just shrink that down a little bit. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and hit the publish on that. So now we've got a dynamic header block for each of our pages, and I'll show you, you know, you might think, well, that's a waste of time because, you know, didn't do a whole lot. So now we've done that, I'm going to save that whole section. I'm going to just go into its little cog here and hit the save section to library. And I'll call it dynamic header or dyn header. Fine header, there we go. Save to library. Just update that page. Now I'll create a new page. I'll bring this page up just so we've got it to view. And what I'm going to do is go to add new. I'm going to create a new page. And we'll put a title in of something that's definitely different from the other one. The new page. Okay. And I'm going to go straight down. I'm going to put a featured image in there. That'll appear behind our header. Let's just drag one that I've downloaded from Unsplash over here. Okay, because it's so light, that one's so dark, I may have to adjust the settings, but we can do that in a minute. Set the featured image. There it is right there. Save a draft quickly. Now I want to use the Divi Builder. I want to build from scratch again. This time, I'm going to hit the new section. I'm going to say add from library. There's our DYN header that we just made. There it is. Get rid of that one up there that we don't want. Publish our page. And let's just take a look at this one with our preview mode here. There we go. There's that new image behind it, which is a bit lighter, but that's fine. You can still read this absolutely fine, so I haven't got a problem with that. So let's actually view the page and compare the two, and you'll see how that dynamic element's actually working for us. Here's the one that we did first, the new content. As you can see, it's got that, and it's got our image. Of course, I've got a blank header up there, so it's going all the way up. But so we got the new content, and if I go to the next new page, there it is. We've got our new image up there. It's changed that to the page title. New content was the old one. The new page was the new one. And it's done the breadcrumbs as well. So we haven't had to change any of that. And every time you create a new page, you'll be able to do that, and it'll automatically update these settings. That's pretty cool stuff right there. And you can do it for plenty of other things on the page. I just thought I'd demonstrate that for you. So once again, well done, Divi. You've done it again. You've come up with some great new innovations that is going to take site building to the next level yet again. So I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web development, have a look down below, take one of our courses. We've got some great free courses, as well as some premium courses with some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. So do take a look. And like I said before, if you want to try out Divi, there's a link below this video. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.